Hi, this is Paul. I want to do a kind of a hot take video on several different subjects, give you my kind of brief opinion about these and kind of do a speed round thing about it. So the first thing I want to talk about is Lin-Manuel Miranda. I saw In the Heights, and I thought it was a very good movie, Washington Heights and that community and stuff, but apparently there's been criticism that he hasn't used any like African Latinos. There weren't enough of them in the movie, apparently. And he apologized, saying that he'd be more careful about this. But this comes to a point where people got to stop whining about things. Okay, I thought it was a great movie, and it celebrated the people that lived there and their culture and everything else. And I know that there's a thing where they say where some Latinos kind of deny their Afro heritage and stuff. But come on, this guy is making entertainment, okay, and he wants to celebrate his community, okay. Okay, you don't have to nitpick everything, okay? And he's not doing it to be malicious, okay? So sometimes these people need to shut up. And I think Rita Moreno said, come on, you stop blaming him for that. He's trying to bring attention to his culture through entertainment, and he's doing a good job. So don't criticize him for everything. Jesus Christ, get over yourself. So I think that's just beyond retarded with that. But anyway, now the next thing I want to talk about also is Jim Jordan. I saw him last night on TV whining, as you usually do, because these Republicans are trying to rewrite history about the insurrection that Donald Trump started when he tried to overturn the results of the election and his enablers in Congress. And I think Jim Jordan was one of the ones in the House that voted to try to overturn certain results in certain states. Okay, first of all, he needs to shut his mouth forever and put on a jacket. That's another thing, because we all know what you didn't see when you were a coach at that school with the wrestling team. So just shut your mouth, Jim Jordan, okay? I'm sick to death of these weak-willed Republicans who act like, Donald Trump is the be-all, get-all of everything, okay? He's a horrible person and a horrible human being, and they have no balls, no guts whatsoever, so screw them, okay? And like I said before in another video, the Democrats need to ram everything through, because the Republicans will do that to you if they get power back. So ram everything through, okay? And if Joe Manchin and Kristen Sinema don't want to get on board, you tell them. If I was Joe Biden, I'd call him to my office, the White House, and I said, I will primary you. I will raise money. I will dedicate it. I will make it my personal mission to make sure that you will never get out of Congress. And I strip your committee assignments and everything, okay, to prove my point, okay? They need to get up and get out of the way and let progress happen, okay? Because these Republicans are trying to restrict voting rights and everything, trying to stop critical race theory, which is, trying to act this police. Enough with them. I'm beyond retarded and sick of them. Okay, now, as far as the basketball is concerned, LeBron and them lost. So, like I said, it was a lot of injuries and stuff, and LeBron is getting old. Okay, so, like I said, and his main guy, Anthony Davis, was just hurt all year, and so was LeBron. So, they're done. So, I'm anxious to see. Unfortunately, now we find out that Chris Paul, he's got COVID. He's going to be put in a protocol. I feel so sorry for him, because he was finally getting ready to go to the Western Final, but now he's got to be in the protocol. So hopefully it's not too long for him and he can actually participate. And I hope for his sake that he can get to the finals, because he's a good guy. So I hope that it works out for him. And in the West and the East, look at that. You're making me forget his name. Kevin Durant. He had a devastating, it was 49 points, and now they got a 3-2 lead, and I feel sorry for the Greek Freak, because I don't think he's never going to win anything with Milwaukee unless he gets another. He needs a sidekick, another partner. But I don't think Milwaukee is never going to give him that. So I think he should leave. But I think he re-signed anyway. But I don't think they're going to win. I think it's going to be the Nets and maybe Phoenix. Okay, and it depends. I guess if Harden and Kyrie comes back, then I think the Nets will beat them. But we'll see how it goes. I would like Chris Paul to get a ring. That would be nice if he can get a ring. Okay, and also what else I wanted to talk about. Okay, movies. Speaking of this, yeah. Now the last rumor that I heard from the Ping Pong Flix channel that maybe Henry Cavill might be in the Flash movie. Okay, I'm just beyond retarded. Hopefully, now that Warner Brothers has sold off part of it to Discovery, they will finally give Henry Cavill, let him be Superman again and stop the BS, okay? If you want to make a separate Superman movie, make the separate Superman movie with the black Superman, but don't call him Clark Kent, okay? Use either Icon, or you can use Val Zod, which I think would be the best thing to do. Stop the BSing, okay? It's just beyond stupid, okay? And also, I want to also make mention, before I go, I'm going to wrap this up with another thing. The whole Murdoch family, I think that they have been devastating to this country, because they're the creators of Fox News. And well, people say, well, Fox News, you know, you got a guy of a conservative voice in the media. But I think them and the Koch brothers have done more harm to this country. They've sown more division in this country. And when it's all said, done, and written, people are going to look back at that and say that the Murdochs creating this Fox News with their implicit bias is probably been more devastating. And of course, the Koch brothers with their money has been, they've really devastated this country and split this country down the middle and for the worst. Okay. And democracy is hanging by a thread with you, when you got these people listening to this idiot Donald Trump and this insurrection. And it's just beyond stupid, that all the stuff that we have to put up with. And that's why I can't stand politicians. They're the absolute worst. And the fact that they can't see this makes it even more devastating. So I just so that's my hot takes on a few subjects. Can let me know what you think down below, and just let me know what you think. Also, I have links to my social media in the description box, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Also, I have a link to my other channel, Paul Views and Opinions. If you check that out. Oh, excuse me. This is Paul's Views and Opinions. I'm sorry about that. A link to my main channel, Trey Passer. That's where most of my videos are, and that's more of an entertainment channel. Also, I have a link to my Patreon channel. It's only $5 a month. I got tons of content on there. Follow the link. It'll take you there. And I also want to thank my patron for supporting me. His name will either be in this video somewhere or in the credits. So please, I want to say thank you to him for supporting me. And hopefully I'll get more patrons in the future. And this is Paul saying so long, and take care.